So I'm Srini Devadas. I've been at MIT 30 years. I've been at CSAIL for about 20. The first part of my career here at MIT, I spent in the Research Laboratory for Electronics. And I work in computer architecture and computer security and the intersections of those two areas. Well, I've been here a while, and over the years, I've worked on many different projects. Some of them are individual projects in the sense that it was just me and my students, and some of them are larger projects. One project that I think affected my career a lot was Project Oxygen, which was started by Michael Dertouzos back in 1999. And it was a five-year project that involved a whole lot of principal investigators from CSAIL and actually other labs as well. And the project was about pervasive computing, and it was ahead of its time. I mean, you think of ubiquitous computing and pervasive computing, and these days in the, 2018, everyone's, thinks of computing as being naturally around us. But back in the late 90s, I felt like Mike had a vision that corresponded to Project Oxygen. And my part of the project was building a hardware that corresponded to devices, either mobile devices or the computers, behind walls that would be intelligent in some fashion and help people interact with computers. My focus really in terms of both the Oxygen project, which was called human-centered computing, and the other projects I've worked on has been building computer systems infrastructure that is useful to people. And from a standpoint of an important metric that I address, infrastructure that's secure. So security means that you want privacy and integrity. Talk about integrity first. It's just that computation should be correct. I mean, it should be what you expect. The privacy aspect is perhaps a little more interesting. That corresponds to you have confidential data, whether your location is private or perhaps it's public for a certain amount of time, but there's obviously data corresponding to, let's say, taxes or the human genome that you want to share with people because you want to get information about it. You want to know if you owe the IRS money or they owe you a refund. You want to send your genome to 23andMe or some other company to analyze. And so you don't want to necessarily give up your data to anybody and everybody, and you want to have some guarantees as to the fact that the data should be kept private. And it obviously is required to be looked at by particular organizations and, let's say, even computer software, but you want to limit that exposure. So I've looked into building computer systems that maintain privacy and integrity properties. And whenever you talk about computer security, you are concerned with the threat model or the adversary. And that's actually, worth the conversation unto itself. But the metrics for computer security come from the threat models. And the guarantees also are under the assumptions of a particular adversary or threat model. You know, I think of computer security as being something that's now really essential. I mean, just like physical security is essential for all of us on the internet, in the computing world, cyberspace, for want of a better term, cybersecurity is really become only more important over the past few years. Just like we want physical security, as I said, I think we want privacy for our data. We want correctness of our computation. So I think of the work that I do as being essential, really, to the evolution of the internet, evolution of pervasive computing, and so on. The particular aspect that I'm most interested in, partly because of my background, is building infrastructure. And in particular, I focus on building processors, so computer processors like the processors that Intel builds. We obviously build things that are much simpler and don't get productized, but I'm focused on building processors that have these security guarantees in place. And I'm a big fan of think about what you want to build for a long time before you build it. So we think of security as being a first-class design metric, just like the performance of computers is a first-class design metric, and the energy, or you know how long the batteries last, is a first-class design metric. And I think of computer security as being a first-class design metric. So yes, I absolutely see a lot of challenges in the future. I think the challenges only are increasing in their, the level of challenge. I think part of it is that there's a conflict really between security and pervasive computing and sharing your data with people and communicating with people. Part of the issue really in computer security is that you can be now attacked by remote adversaries, and by that I mean people who are connected to the internet just like you are connected to the internet, except that they're nowhere close to you. You know, they're in different continents. They are attacking you when, well, you're sleeping, but obviously, you know, the internet doesn't sleep. And you have to now worry about how you know, potent those attacks will be. You have to worry about how much they know about your system. In many cases, because systems are complicated, the person who's designed the system, or a piece of the system, I should say, doesn't know a whole lot about the entirety of the system, the interfaces between the component that he or she has designed and other components. But there's adversaries who make it their business, attackers who make it their business to know a whole lot about the system, because again, you know, the internet is helpful in giving them access and also learning more about the system. And so they're willing to spend a whole lot of time, you know, casing the joint, you know, for want of a better term. And this is obviously something that they have access to through their internet connection, as I said. And they can spend a lot of time figuring out what your weaknesses are. And what it really means is that, you know, from a challenge standpoint, is we have to now spend the equivalent amount of time, and perhaps more time, thinking about potential attacks before we design our systems. And so in that sense, I think because of the potency of the adversary, I think the challenges are only gotten greater. I'd say that from a standpoint of intent, you know, over the past few years, I think our intent has been clear right from the beginning. That is that we want to build secure systems, you know, from the ground up. What has changed really is that it's been surprising to me, you know, as to the types of attacks that these systems have to withstand. And so you think about these attacks that happen over the internet, they're remote attacks, they're software attacks, but sometimes there's attacks that are associated with the human error, that just clicking on something that you shouldn't click on, and this is an employee of a company who clicks on something that he or she shouldn't click on. There's also insider attacks, and this may be by an unknowing employee or someone who doesn't know what he or she is doing because they've brought a device into the perimeter, the security perimeter, that's already been compromised. Or it could be someone who's wanting to commit industrial espionage. And so the variety of attacks, I think, has been surprising to me, even though I'm a researcher in the field and I try to think about the potential for different attacks. And so in that sense, I think the intent has changed in that the designs that we've had to build, you know, halfway through building them, we've kind of gone and said, oh, I guess we need to change the design now because of this new type of attack that's really come up. And these attacks are really weaponized by people. The attackers share information amongst themselves, and the attacks get more potent, you know, as the attackers know more about particular systems or about how generic systems are designed. So ultimately, like I said, I think our long-term goal is build secure systems that have high performance and low energy consumption, you know, from the ground up, treat security as a first-class design parameter. And there are many aspects to that, corresponding to the type of system you want to build. Is it an Internet of Things system? You know, that would involve physical proximity of it, of the threat model in the threat model. If it's simply a cloud computing framework, you know, that would involve perhaps a simpler threat model in relation to IoT, Internet of Things, where you're perhaps only concerned with a remote adversary. I'd say that you're really in a situation where you'd like to build things, prototype things with these metrics in mind. And I think our hope is that as we've prototyped these systems and we learn more about building them, that our ideas are picked up by companies that build computer infrastructure, the Microsofts and the Amazons on one side, and the Intels and the AMDs on the other, because ultimately software does run on computer hardware, and you have to have that hardware to be high performant and low energy consuming to do the work that you want it to do. But having said that, I do think that there's a lot of problems in the cybersecurity space that can be solved through appropriate hardware design. And I'd say that's really been my primary focus over the last 10 years to help the security of software systems through appropriate hardware design.